friends along the way. I might be speaking from up here, or I might be in the back of the room, so please turn to me whenever I speak and listen carefully. This would be a very good time to silence your cell phones. And by silence, I don't mean vibrate. That is very disruptive to the actor. So please silence your cell phones. And if you think you're gonna need a candy or a cough drop or some sort of annoying little wrapping, you know, wrapped candy or anything, please, this is a good time to unwrap it, have it by your seat and all ready to take if you need it. That's what we do at the symphony. Now, let's get on with our play, Clueless in Colorado. Act one, in a seedy little office in downtown Estes Park, the phone rings.
It's an annoying sound.
Can't be the phone, that never rings.
What the? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, wrong end.
Keep your pants on, keep your pants on.
What? Huh? Who?
Just the facts, ma'am, just the facts.
Us? Really?
You'll pay. We'll take the case.
Bye!
Sowie.
My name is Joe. Joe Friday. Got that call on a Saturday. She was young, blonde, and beautiful. How do I know these things? Well, I could tell by her voice. But most of all, she was desperate. I started out with the basics. What can we do for you, sugar? What's your name, sugar?
Sunday.
Okay. And what can we do for you there, Sunday?
A couple of my friends went missing.
When was that?
Monday.
Did you call a fuzz?
Of course, Friday. First thing Tuesday.
What do they have to say?
They put out an APB on Wednesday. Told me to call back Thursday.
And did you, Sunday?
Yeah, but there was nothing new. They said to stick by the phone. They called me on Friday.
And?
Same old song and dance. They left me in the lurch. That's why I'm talking to you, Friday, on Saturday.
You see, folks, that's why we never get any business around here. I've been through basically a whole week's worth of you on this case already, and we haven't even started to look for that missing couple. Hey, Mary, Shirley, get out of here. I got big news. Huh? Nice of you to get all dressed up for work today.
Hey, Joe, what's up?
Yeah, what's up, Joe?
Well, the SPDA has an actual case. Yep. I'm Joe.
I'm Mary.
I'm Shirley.
And we're known as
the Smarty Pants Detective Agency.
SPDA, Smarty Pants. Way more time on running. Always anytime. They're all listening.
Check out our website. Call us. We have time. We got all the
time.
Mary Jo.
Look, I'm not just trying to make you feel good like I usually do. We've been hired for a big-time detective case.
Yes, yes. What is it?
Well, we got a call from this chick, see? Seems a couple of her friends went missing, and she wants us to find them. Okay. What could be simpler than that? I mean, what could possibly go wrong? Well,
who is it?
Do we know them?
Well, let's just see. Yeah, their names are Jim and Kathy Lysite. Or Lysin. Or Lysin. Or Lucy. Or Latex. Laxative. Who cares what their name is?
It's money in the bank. That's what matters.
Money in the bank? You mean someone's actually going to pay us?
Yep. If we find the missing couple.
Yeah.
No problem.
And don't go missing ourselves.
Well, that's
and then number three is, probably shouldn't tell you about three yet. So,
there's always a catch every time we get a case. What is it this time?
Yeah, you gotta find out sooner or later. You see, that missing couple, they were last seen in the Stanley Hotel.
Whoa. But isn't that place haunted?
Well, technically, it's haunted, but we really need the money. We're broke.
Yeah, we haven't had a decent case in 5 years. All we ever do is chase cheating spouses around this town, collecting evidence in divorce cases. I'm bored.
Yeah, but everybody around here knows that place is haunted. I mean, we could go in there and we could be murdered or killed to death.
What's the difference? We need the cash.
No, I don't need any cash. I got a nice job at the bowling alley cleaning pins and balls. I need to go in the Stanley Hotel like I need another hole in my head.
Well, I'm the one that gets up at 4 o'clock every morning, delivers newspapers, shoveling snow in this chump town, and for what? Chump change, that's what. Oh, once in a while I get a cup of hot chocolate with some cute little marshmallows in it from some old bag. But we need this money desperately. We're going to find those Leeseys, period.
Leesey? I think I know that name. Are they from Wisconsin? And how did they get here anyway?
Coincidentally enough, they are from Wisconsin. Hmm. They drove out of Wisconsin, across the great state of Iowa, into Nebraska. There he is right there.
Nebraska!
Inside jokes, folks, we get them every year enough. Then into Colorado. You see, the Leeseys, they're having a huge reunion up in Estes Park. And the day before that couple went missing, the whole herd of them took a tour of the Stanley Hotel.
Joe.
I'm from Madison, Wisconsin at one point in my life. I think I might know this Jim Leesey. It's the same guy. He was best friends with Pete. I knew Pete. I went to high school with him. Oh, this is a nice couple. We have to find them.
No. I am not going in the Stanley Hotel.
All for one and one for all.
Yeah? I'm for myself.
No.
We go together on this.
Mm-hmm. Safety in numbers.
Remember?
Understood.
She's got that look in her eye.
I know.
She's
going to
bowl.
Watch it.
Get it!
Every time she crawls under this desk, it takes us 2 hours to get her. Come
on. Hey, what's the matter with you?
Now, snap out of it, Mary. We can't let fear control us.
Besides, everybody's got to die sometime.
Oh, that makes me feel so much better.
Well, the words of the great Winston Churchill Downs, there's nothing to fear but fear itself.
Yeah, and ghosts.
Ghosts.
If you're so afraid, I'll go first.
Okay.
Yeah, you okay? Yeah. Come on, Porcupine, get out of here, come on. Do the pudding head, what are you waiting for?
Sleuths inching their way towards the dark and haunted Stanley Hotel. In the middle of the night! Sections of the hotel have been deserted for many years and are really run down. What awaits our alleged, what do we call them? Detectives?
Oh,
Hey, you guys, the coast is clear. Come on out.
Are you sure, Joe?
Absolutely not. But it sure is scary. Come on.
Joe, I just don't understand why I have to search for this hotel in the middle of the night when it's pitch dark. Joe, we're starting to head toward the woods.
So what?
I want to go toward the woods. Do you know how crazy people travel through the woods? Huh. They take the psychopath.
Something's coming up ahead. There's a silhouette of something big.
Huge
earth, do we all have to stand on the same exact spot? Hold it. Found something here in the weeds. Brush that up. I think it might be a sign. Can you read that?
Stanley.
Oh,
no.
A clue. Usually we're clueless in Colorado, but think of a name.
Well, if we hadn't been looking in the middle of the night, we might have noticed this huge building.
Yeah.
I'm gonna look through the windows. I wanna see if we can see anything inside.
I want my mommy.
Oh, she's having a meltdown.
She's head of the psychopath. Aaron, come in. We gotta calm down. We gotta stay in the game.
Yeah.
Alright, come on.
Come on.
Alright, let's see. What can we do to calm her down? I know. How about an equipment check?
Okay.
Yeah.
Ready? Pencils.
Check.
I might want to get the lead out.
Check.
Notepads.
Check.
Check.
Very good. Now for the easy one. Flashlights.
Check.
Come on, Captain Kangaroo. It's got to be in that pouch somewhere.
Check.
I'm almost afraid to ask. Do they work?
Well, of course they work.
It's a big door.
I want to go first.
All right, let me take the lead. Go ahead there, put it in.
Thanks a lot.
Wait, should I get it first?
Oh, looks like we're in the old section of the hotel. It's really run down. Look at how dark and dusty it is down here.
It stinks in here.
Yeah. Why don't you go down there, Mary, and check out that smell? Look at all these antiques in here. And these chandeliers. Oh, they're just beautiful.
You guys notice this sheet on the wall? What the heck? Hey, what could happen if we looked?
I don't know, we could die.
Yeah.
Well, let's look.
Okay.
At the columns we think. One, two,
three.
Ooh.
Check it out. But I'm going to do it the sane way. Go by myself, in the dark, with no backup. That's how they do it on Kojak.
Sounds like a plan, Joe. See ya. Wouldn't want to be ya.
You don't want to see me go? Well, look, I'll probably come back alive, maybe. You stay here, you chickens stay here and hold out the coop. I'll be back, hopefully.
Oh, Joe. Shirley? Let's go back to the bowling alley. He can find his way
Mary,
back.
Mary, we can't leave Joe. He might need our help.
No, he can find his way back.
Oh, Mary, he's going to need our help. You know Joe can't find his way out of a paper bag.
Oh, yeah.
Look, I'm kind of glad that you and I have a little bit of time to ourselves anyway.
Okay.
I've been thinking a lot about this Jim and Kathy Lisi. I feel like I just don't know enough about them. I mean, are they famous or something? What do you know about
them? Well, I know that Kathy is a teacher in a big-time fancy school in Florida. And I know that Jim is a... Think about it. I don't know what the heck Jim does. Oh, but I know that he likes to go bass fishing, and he likes to cook turkeys in one of those big, deep, fat fryer things.
Oh, yeah, I've seen those. Oh, that's a cool invention.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to get one of those.
Yeah.
So Joe gives me a raise.
Yeah.
Okay, look. You know he's going to be back, and he'll start yelling at us. So we better divide and conquer. You go down this corridor, you investigate everything down this way. Now I'm going to go all the way down and investigate this way. Okay? I'll meet you back here in a half an hour. All right?
Okay.
Mary, I told you to go down and investigate that corridor.
I did.
You were gone 2 seconds.
I'm done.
Interesting. No reaction.
question. Make a note of that.
He blinked. He blinked.
Must have been your imagination.
He blinked.
Right. Document it. All right. Mary, look. He's turned his head. Look.
No, he didn't.
Mary, huh? He didn't look. He turned his head.
I don't see it. Maybe I need to get my glasses.
Oh, yeah, I think. Yeah. Well, she come a little closer, too. Yes, he turned his head. Now, document this. Joe needs to know.
Joe needs to
Mary, huh? Now he's turned his head toward me.
No, he didn't.
Shirley, you can see that.
He did not turn his head and don't call me Shirley.
I must document this too. Joe will be out soon.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Boo!
Hey, Shirley, you got got a cold there. Here, I got a Kleenex for you. You're
sneezing.
Joe, I'm fine.
What the?
Seth.
Same thing. I thought that Patrick coughed. It can't be. You're coming down with something pretty bad. Hey, look, I got some rope to get the top.
Joe, I told you, I feel fine.
That was disgusting. That's what I mean. Look around, you belch right in front of all these nice people. You need to excuse yourself. What, you have Polish sausages for lunch?
Joe, I told you, I didn't do anything.
Joe. Is it tight, Shirley?
Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
Did you see that? She came right out of that picture. Yeah.
The picture frame. Oh, it's terrible. I think so. I mean, gotta admit, I've never heard a picture sneeze before.
Well, I've never heard a picture cough before.
Well, this is not to sneeze at. We need to take some act. If there's nobody trying to drive the SP detectives out of the Stanley Hotel, what's this giant gungo butcher knife doing back here?
I told you he had a knife. They're gonna come after us. They're gonna kill us. They're gonna take that knife. And they're gonna stab it into my stomach. It's gonna go.
Wow, that sounds like it could hurt. Well, we gotta take some action, and I mean right now.
Well, what's the plan, Joe?
Well, simple, the plan is... Wait, I don't have a plan for the murder scenario.
You don't have a plan?
Nope, but I have an idea.
Well, what's your idea?
Get the heck out of here! Go, Shirley, go! Oh,
no. Where are we?
I don't know. Please, you! You should have taken that tour with the police. Gotta be 80,000 square feet.
Yowza! Check out those state-of-the-art appliances.
We better get going. That ghost is right behind us.
Yikes!
Go!
We're back into familiar territory.
Oh, how gorgeous.
Hi, Shirley.
Well, hi, Joe. Over here, if it isn't Sleeping Beauty, risen from the dead. Mind if I ask you a question there, Mary?
No, not at all.
Where in the heck have you been? Shirley and I back there getting... I mean, she got people driving us in the car, burying us in the ground. I mean, what are you doing?
I was taking a nap, Joe. I found a nice little closet back there, and I went in and I took a nap, because my nerves are frazzled.
Right. Well, you know what you need? What? Good, stiff drink.
Oh, yeah.
Got any booze on you?
Oh.
Check it out, there, Captain Kangaroo. See what you got.
No booze. Hey! Hmm? I bet we could go and find some Kool-Aid in the kitchen.
Good luck with that. The kitchen's 80,000 square feet. Oh. You can fit a whole school system in that kitchen.
Oh. I like Kool-Aid.
Yeah, I do too. Remember that commercial on TV when we were kids? A little frosted pitcher and these smiling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there's a jingle.
Yeah, but I got a song.
Not Jingle Bell.
No. That's a song. Well, let's sing it.
Okay.
Ah, Kool-Aid, it tastes great. I wish I had some. Can't wait.
Yeah, that was pretty pathetic, wasn't it?
Hey, maybe they'll want to sing with us. Want to sing with us?
Yeah!
Okay. At the count of three. One, two, three.
A Kool-Aid. It tastes great. Wish we had some. Can't wait.
Yikes!
Kool-Aid can make any glass of water taste better.
Yeah. Even bath water.
He hit me in the head for
it. Hit you in the head?
What, my hat's all dented?
Damn, I didn't hit you.
I didn't dent myself. I hit you in the head, didn't you?
I Jennifer. Joe, what are you hitting me in the head for?
You hollered at me for.
You hit me in the head.
Do not, I'm over here minding my own business.
You hit me in the head.
Did not.
Did two?
Did not.
Did two?
Not.
Did two?
Not.
Did two? Did not.
Did two? Did not. I don't even know.
Wait a minute.
But if nobody's hitting you in the head, nobody's hitting me in the head, or somebody's hitting us in the head, who's hitting us in the head?
Maybe it was a ghost.
Maybe it's a ghost. There's no such thing as a ghost.
Joe! Huh?
There's no such thing as a ghost.
Where did this come from?
I don't know.
I don't know, Joe. I don't know, Joe.
My family says to go.
Hey, guys!
Huh?
Do you notice this tear in the wallpaper?
No.
Look, there's a note.
What does it say?
I don't know.
Here, you could use my binoculars.
Sure. Why not?
What does it say?
Oh, someone left this for us. It's directions.
Yeah.
Looks like a secret passage to the attic.
Oh, yeah.
No. We gotta go to the attic. There's too many unanswered questions.
Yes, and did you notice that each one of these portraits has a name tag? This was the governess of the Stanley
She's
Hotel.
She's pretty.
This was the caretaker.
He's from France.
And the head housekeeper.
She's hot.
I do believe we have ourselves three suspects.
Bing.
Another word we should be familiar with, but aren't. Suspects, I think that's good. Uh-huh. After all, who or what would try to drive SPD detectives from the Stanley Hotel? Which of these ghosts are real and which aren't? What's the motive for taking Jim and Kathy anyway? Jim's not that much fun to be with. There's gotta be some connection.
Well, are Jim and Kathy even still in this house? What if they're dead?
My fault.
It happens.
Oh, I don't like dead bodies. I don't like dead bodies at all. I mean, remember that case we worked on last year in Denver? It was a murder-suicide. A man killed his wife. And then he killed himself in the head with a gun 6 times. That was the bloodiest, ickiest case we ever worked on.
Yeah. We never did solve that case.
And all says blubbering over the past. Let's get to that end.
Will our bumbling detectives ever solve this case? Will Jim and Kathy Lisi ever be found? Will the SPDA ever find documents to support their case?
Hey, look! I found official documents to support our case!
Really?
Yeah! Joe, there's all kinds of boxes up here in the attic. We gotta go through this stuff.
Hey, look! There's another whole room back there.
Wow. Well, you're a detective. Why don't you go check it out, Marky Pine? Oh, when you're back there, if you find a gigantic, bloody butcher knife, don't let it bother you.
I can't see.
Oh, what's the matter with you?
My eyes are closed.
Oh, my God.
Harry, when you get back there, please turn the light on.
Send her back to cosmetology school.
Goodness.
We're all of
them. Hey, guys!
Yeah?
I found a suitcase.
Brilliant.
Are you in the monster?
Well, there's this. I think it's a double-barreled slingshot. Oh, and some candies.
You kidding? That looks like a sail off some guy's boat.
This.
Mary?
Huh?
What are you looking for?
Jim and Kathy Lisi.
In a suitcase? All right, I found something that I think is really important.
Yeah?
It's the death certificate for the caretaker.
Hang on to that, Joe. That's important evidence.
Bing. Another word we should have looked at in the glossary. Anyway, I'll hang on to it. It looks important.
Joe. Oh, Joe, look. Oh. I found the death certificates for the governess and the head housekeeper. Looks like they all died in 1867. Oh, and look, they even have the official seal of approval.
Here's an article about that caretaker guy. It says he was very possessive of the Stanley Hotel. What? The spirit's been seen flying over the city many times. People know he's a ghost. And he does not like intruders.
Are we intruders?
Think of it this way, Porcupine. Do we live here?
No.
I don't know, reading through these articles? Reading through these articles, I don't know how to say this, but these three were quite the drinkers.
That's right. Here's another article about that caretaker. Mm. Well, he sure gets a lot of ink in the Estes Globe Herald Review Journal Times Tribune. Big town, I guess. Anyway, it says here he's been picked up many times for OHI.
OHI? What's OHI?
Operating a horse while intoxicated.
Joe, there's got to be a wine cellar around here somewhere.
Indubitably. For sure. Hey, Mary, what are you doing back there? We gotta get going.
I found another case. Hold on a second.
Is it a trunk?
Yeah.
Is that your new hip?
Yeah, you should know.
What else do we know here? I have a question for you.
Do you think that the rest of the Leeseys even care?
Yeah!
Do the Leeseys care?
Yeah!
Do you think Jim and Kathy will ever be found?
Yeah!
I don't know. This is not convincing me. I think the Leeseys seem to be quite fine without them pair of Floridians.
Oh no!
Are those wizard detectives finally gone?
I think so.
It's gonna take them a long time to find the wine cellar.
What a bunch of idiots. It took them forever to figure out that we're really dead. We ran this place over 150 years ago.
Yeah, idiots.
Well, I kind of like that Joe Friday guy. He reminds me of someone.
I like Scaredy Mary.
Shirley is definitely the brains of the outfit.
Yeah, brains.
Yummy.
Yep, they're gone. You can relax.
Oh, thank goodness.
Sure. Man, I'm starting to get a little stiff. You know what? These cobwebs in my mouth got to go back to 1867. Here, you want some?
Well, I sure don't like being stuck in this picture frame whenever humans are around.
Yeah, me either.
Hey, am I really dead?
I don't know, but you sure smell like it.
You know, we may be three spirits from beyond, but those Leeseys have more spirit than the three of us put together. And they put on a darn good reunion, too.
They've had us traveling all over the country. We've been to Utah, Washington, Colorado, California, and now we're back in Wisconsin again. Oh, the Leesey spirit is going strong. I'll tell you, they were really quite the bunch to handle when they were younger.
I should say so. You know, I was invisible being a ghost and all, but I spent a ton of hours floating above the crowd at the Anchor Inn in Madison, Wisconsin. I saw a Leesey in there most of the time, especially Barbara. That brother Jim, the guy who rented the apartment right above the tavern, he was in there all the time.
Yeah, you know that, Pat.
Huh?
In high school, he spent more time in the principal's office than he did in class. In fact, his homeroom was the detention hall. But he was a very generous soul. Over the years, he played a card game with Peg, and he let her win thousands of dollars.
I wonder what ever happened to the cottage on Lake Quiet. Oh, the Leeseys used to spend a lot of time there in the summer.
Yeah, and in the wintertime, they would go to Albert Park, and they would play on the toboggan, and they would go sliding down those icy trails really fast, until one day, Johnny Wango and Mary smashed into a tree. She had to have stitches. I hope he's a better driver now.
Don't bet your life on it.
And remember when the whole family would go to the St. Denis Festival?
Oh my God.
Sue loved to play the fishing game. She'd win all those little toy prizes. And loved to go to every single booth, every time.
Nervous as a mouse, still is. Well, you two aren't the only ones that have been tracking their lives all these years. I remember when their dad used to take them out on Lake Mendota and go perch fishing.
Oh, yeah.
And Sunday mornings, cutest thing you ever saw, the whole tribe would come marching out of 309 Dempsey, go down the street, go into the church, take up the front pew from one end. That path he always had to sit next to mom or dad, or sometimes right in between them. I don't know what that was about. But their brother Jerry, he got to sit wherever he wanted in the pew. You know why? Because he was going to go to the seminary.
He He was an angel. There are a million stories, but eventually they all grew up. Some got married, some had kids of their own.
Yeah, let's not forget about their brother Mark. He met a nice young lady and got married. They had two nice young daughters. And you know what? Pretty soon Mark was living his dream of driving a big rig down the highway. Speaking of big rigs going down the highway, Jim and his pal Pete one day loaded up the truck. They headed to Tucson, Arizona to hang drywall. A most glamorous career, I might add. But that's where Jim met Kathy. It was love at first sight. I sure hope those goofy guys and the shorty pants find that couple before it's too late. I mean, do we have to do all the work around here?
Yeah, you know, as the governess, I stuck around because I wanted to watch the children grow up and move on. But they're all grown up and gone now. I think I might be ready to move on myself.
I've been thinking about it for a little while myself. I'm in debt for 150 years. What do they need my help around here for? I'm ready to move on.
Well, I was the head housekeeper. But they have a lot of new staff here now. I don't think I'm needed anymore either.
Well then, I think we're out of here.
Go south!
this wasn't one of them. But in the end, when the case was solved, everyone came out a winner. Jim and Kathy Lisi, who were never really lost to begin with, were now found. The three ghosts vacated the Stanley Hotel and they went off to spook some other city. And the Smarty Pants Detective Agency, they went on to have a brilliant career after this, at least according to their standards. But over the next 50 years, they had almost a dozen more calls. And that voluptuous Dame Sunday, who called on that fateful Saturday looking for Friday, she was so happy to get her friends back on Monday that she promptly wrote us a check on Tuesday. Cashed in Wednesday and spent it Thursday. On what? New Smarty Pants, of course. For Joe, Mary, and Shirley. The end.
All right. Woo-hoo.